Hi everybody, this is Mrs. Gurmeet. Today I'm going to be explaining to you the second chapter of Business Studies, Principles of Management. Before we proceed, I expect everybody to open your book to page number 30. And everybody should have a pen so that we can do the required marking. We may follow the same pattern as we do it in the class, right? So, we're first going to understand what are principles of management. Principles are nothing but broad guidelines. These broad guidelines help us. They're also your yardsticks. They help us to attain a vision. They also determine the different ways in which you could achieve your vision. Principles are also sometimes your general propositions, which tell you how to achieve your vision. As we move ahead, here if you see, on that chapter, on that page 30 below, it's given. Principles serve as broad guidelines. They are stating the vision as well as how to achieve it. If you turn to page number 32, we have very clearly here what is the definition of a principle of management. It is nothing but a broad and general guideline which helps us in decision making and behavior. See, whenever you want to decide something in an organization, for example, if my superior has to give me a promotion, he has to have some guidelines or some, a yardstick or some ways and means in which he's going to. We have very clearly here what is the definition of a principle of management. It is nothing but a broad and general guideline which helps us in decision making and behavior. See, whenever you want to decide something in an organization, for example, if my superior has to give me a promotion, he has to have some guidelines or some, a yardstick or some ways and means in which he's going to consider me for the promotion. So, these principles help you to take a decision. We are first going to understand what is the difference between the management principles and the principles of science. As taught to you in the earlier chapter, and you've been studying all your life, you know what is science. Science is something which is very rigid. Science is something which has principles and which cannot be changed at the whims and fancies of the investigators or the scientists, etc. So, scientific principles are very rigid, whereas management principles are not that rigid because management deals with human beings. And I've also already told you, human beings are very complex, unpredictable in nature. And then it's very important that human beings have a human behavior, which is applied very creatively and which is never static or the same in all situations. Hence, management principles are a little flexible because they have to be applied according to the situation and scientific questions. Hence, management principles are a little flexible because they have to be applied according to the situation and scientific principles are rigid. So this is one board question which is made from 1 mark to 3 marks. If you look on page number 33, can you see closely? We have the second difference between principles of management and techniques of management. I won't repeat what are principles. Keep in mind they are your guidelines which help you to take a decision. Whereas techniques are nothing but methods, procedures of doing a particular work. If you have to bake a cake, there is a technique. You can't do it as you wish. So there is a technique of doing the work. But how to make it, when to make it, you have to use your own principles. The third difference we're going to understand is the difference between principles of management and values. We all are bound by some values. You know very well what are values. They are your moral connotations. Moral connotations, matlab, these are the values which have been imbibed in us right from our childhood, perhaps. Values cannot be based on research. Values cannot be, technical nature. Values are something which decide an individual behavior. How is that person going to behave in the society? How is that person going to behave at his home? His behavior is based on his values. Values are something which decide an individual behavior. How is that person going to behave in the society? How is that person going to behave at his home? His behavior is based on his values. But let us not forget one thing. When we are practicing our principles of management, you cannot ignore the fact that some values, some responsibilities which are accepted by the society, maybe social, maybe ethical, have to be observed while conducting the principles. So I've taught you three things, children. One, what is the difference between principles of management and scientific principles? Two, what is the difference between techniques and principles of management? Three, what is the difference between values and principles of management? The next topic what we're going to understand is the nature of principles of management. Here there are two questions which you need to understand very clearly. This is on page number 33 again. The first question is, how are the principles of management derived or developed? It may be a 3 marks question. It's very simple. The management principles are derived on three bases, if you look carefully. One, on the basis of observation, I shall explain, experimentation, and personal experiences of the manager. Now, one fine day you get up and say, today I'm going to do this. That cannot be called a principle. For principle, you have to observe repeatedly under the same conditions. Only then it becomes a principle. If you see Newton's principle, there are three principles of Newton. The first principle says every action has an equal reaction. He did not make it one fine day. He observed that when he threw an apple up, it came down because of the gravitational pull. He experimented it repeatedly. Ek din mein principle nahi banta. Aapko baar baar wo cheez karni padti hai. Aur fir kahin jaakar aap sochoge ki, haan, shayad main ye karun to theek ho sakta hai. Again, personal experiences. What may be for you good may not be good for me. Principles may vary because, as I've already told you, management principles are flexible. Suppose I have an organization with just 10 people and you have an organization with 100 people. And if I say I am going to adopt the principle of centralization and you say I too, it may not work. Because for me it may work because I have only 10 people. Centralization matlab sara kuch I will decide. But agar tum bolo ki 100 logon ke saath tum hi sab kuch decide karo, it's not possible. You need people down the levels to take a decision. So we are going to understand this a little more in detail when we are going to do the principles. So management principles are derived on three bases. One, on the basis of observation. Two, experimentation. Three, personal experiences of the manager. Let me tell you something interesting. There is a nature of the principles of management. The principles of management are both science and art. Can you see this line here on page 33? Science and art. What does it mean? We've already understood science is scientific knowledge. In science, there are some guidelines. In science, there is cause and effect relation. Science apni marzi se nahi hoti hai. So, jab hum principles padhte hain, it is science. Right? Jab hum principles ko apply karte hain, wo art hai. Kyun? Jab hum unhe observe karte hain, experiment karte hain, wo science hai. Jab hum use apply karte hain aur personal experiences hain, to wo art hai. I'll give you a very good example of a doctor. Let's say, to become a doctor, you need to do a 5.5 years of MBBS. That theoretical knowledge which you study in that five and a half years is your science. ठीक है? उसमें बहुत सारे observations हैं, experimentations हैं, बहुत कुछ तुम वो science में पढ़ते हो. लेकिन हर doctor एक ही तरीके से वो scientific knowledge को apply नहीं करता. You have two pediatricians. दोनों पीडियाट्रिक्स की अपनी बच्चों को हैंडल करने का तरीका अलग है, तो वो क्या बन गया? आर्ट. सो प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट आर बोथ साइंस एंड आर्ट. साइंस इज द थियोरिटिकल पार्ट, द एप्लीकेशन पार्ट वी कॉल इट हियर. यू सी, कैन यू सी दिस क्रिएटिव एप्लीकेशन इज रिगार्डेड एज एन आर्ट. सो चिल्ड्रन, वी आर डन विद पेज नंबर 32, 33. And we've done 4 to 5 questions here. I'm not going to be doing the features and importance right now because I need to quote many examples. In the next video, we are going to be understanding the 14 fuels principles. So kindly turn to page number 54.